principals, teachers, parents, oh boys, students, ladies and gentlemen. As the daughter of an outstanding oh boy of the first public school in Hong Kong, it gives me privilege as you count me in the QC family. After all the hardship of COVID-19, you can now come together with social distancing to honor another milestone of QC. Rescheduling celebrations must be a toiling job, but that is exactly the QC motto, and indeed my father's passion for QC throughout his entire life, which tied in with the theme of your anniversary, serving the community. I was excited to take a look at your school's records to know more about my father's life as a QC boy. I can easily identify him in a dozen of chapters in which he was once described as lively, handsome, and younger than most of his classmates. From scraping through the exams, to working with a will, from seeing patients queuing for dentists to looking at Belilio's girls in a new haircut, from getting a government scholarship to pursuing science in the University of Hong Kong, from his career in Macau to tremendous contributions to the country, Hong Kong and Macau. I shall stop short here to let you see for yourselves how life almost one century ago was as interesting as my father's word of wisdom and humor. These stories are never ending. So as your predecessor's sense of service to QC and the community in the past 160 years, when we flip through The Yellow Dragon, the first Chinese school magazine in Hong Kong, first published in 1899, you will find lots of outstanding figures across generations of Hong Kong. Your honorary advisors come from diverse professions. As products of this grassroots school for everyone, they ascend the social ladder and become your role models in giving of ourselves for the greater good, especially in this epidemic. This is the QC character Hong Kong should embrace. The schooling here is therefore key to molding your manhood, your mind, and your bodies, as laid down in the full version of your school song. I am immensely delighted to be joined by your former principals today. Their visionary leadership, alloyed with illustrious hard work of so many teachers, brought QC to where she is today as the cradle of leaders of tomorrow. Coupled with staunch support from old boys and parents, I have every confidence that you will continue to chant the QC melody in the face of uncertainties and challenges. It brings me warmth, in particular, when I read what my father said about the time when he switched from arts to the new Faculty of Science at the Hong Kong U, and I quote, "I'm very grateful for my years in Class 2 and Class 1 at Queen's, and for my time at the university. I learned to be independent. I learned the meaning of life. I had a very good headmaster and teachers at Queen's. I was happy there. QC boys, I hope you are too. My family is honored that our father played a part in the many QC stories. A lucky person's lifetime is cured by childhood, while an unlucky person's lifetime is spent curing childhood. QC boys are all fortunate, for you have the best brotherhood of the city. I look forward to more people of Hong Kong to be touched by the QC stories and healed by the QC therapy in both the best and worst of times. Thank you very much."
Ladies and gentlemen, happy birthday to Queen's College. It gives me exceptional honor to share the joy of this distinguished institution on behalf of my late grandfather. Further to his last speech on this very stage of his alma mater 2 decades ago, when you celebrated the 140th anniversary. Myself, as the father of 3 kids, I know how bad you feel in the past few months under Omicron. The pandemic brings fear and worries to families and additional stress to candidates who have just completed their DSE. Education should not only be Zoom and online classes, but also schooling and fellowship. It is time to resume some of the activities safely, especially your sports lessons and school teams training. With all-time commitment to sports at the regional and national level, my grandfather is our role model on sports. Sports bring both competition and cohesion. We would all recall the pride we take when the Hong Kong-China delegation triumphed in the Tokyo Olympics with the best result in history. Behind the pride and success of every sportsman and woman is countless practice, which exemplifies the school's motto of QC. Team sports test our determination to break through limitations together with strength and perseverance. These are fine attributes necessary for the ongoing pandemic fight, and in fact, along your way beyond QC. I have ample opportunity to meet and work with many of your seniors, including the incumbent Commissioner for Sports, Mr. T.K. Yuang, Yuang Dakkeung, who's also one of your honorary advisors of the anniversary. To me, QC boys excel in academics and activities with a high sense of service to the community and a caring heart for the underprivileged. As Michael Jordan said, talent wins games, but teamwork and intelligence win championships. Sportsmanship and indeed unity are what would bring our city back on track today. So we are looking for talents who are responsive and adaptable to rise to the challenge. With the good deeds of teachers and alumni, as well as your unremitting hard work, I'm sure generation of QC will continue to be the backbone of the success of our city, Hong Kong. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to offer my heartfelt congratulations for my alma mater, Queen's College, for the 160th anniversary birthday celebration. I'm most delighted to join you on this happy occasion from afar. Right now, I'm living in Singapore. Although I have not been able to join the launch ceremony in January, and I have not also been physically be with you at this time, I like to celebrate the birthday of our school for such a long history. After months of lockdown, we can finally see each other, greet each other, hug each other, and celebrate this important milestone of our alma mater together. COVID has changed the whole world, and in this post-pandemic world, things will never be the same. But Hong Kong has gone through many changes before, including the plague over a century ago, and also SARS in 2003. All this infectious disease outbreak have made significant changes of our society and of our nation, and indeed for the whole world. However, Queen's College will still stand be the same as the beacon of education in many, many generations. And I'm sure our QC boys will continue to honor the school and to be educated and lead the society and our country in many ways for the years and decades to come. So I offered my heartiest congratulations to everyone in Queen's College and everyone who graduated from this college and for many successful years to come. Happy birthday.